Hey everybody, it's Michelle Caswell from Purely His. Road trip time. I'm up in the Portland area. I'm about 40 minutes away from my destination and wanted to pull over really quick and use some Starbucks Wi-Fi so that I would have a better connection and just touch base with you guys and just share something that's on my heart. So let's wait for a second till a few people get on here. I know it's during the day, so it's different than what we've been doing, but I wanted to make sure that I was being consistent and doing it every single week. So here I am at the lunch hour. I guess it'd be the lunch hour if you're on the West Coast, not the East Coast. So, hey, Shannon, I had a feeling you would be able to watch because I think you're homesick, huh? Like, yay, at least we have one person. Are you still sick, Shannon? Let's see, delayed reaction. I think she is still sick. I was praying for her on my way up here. Well, I am 40 minutes away from my destination, being the speaker at the women's retreat that God saved my life at. And there's just something I really wanted to just kind of get out there. It's part of my message for this weekend. You know, in the Word of God, it talks about how, you know, describes Satan and it describes God. And you know, one of the ways it describes Satan is that he came to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus came to give us life and life abundantly. And, you know, on my way up here, I'm like flipping through all these different channels. And I usually only listen to Christian music, but because I don't know all the stations through all the towns I'm going through, I just have to like flip and, you know, see what's on. And there was a song that came on that was like totally a song from my past. It was that flash dance song, What a Feeling. And I just, as I was like listening to it, I was just like, whatever, I'm just going to crank it up. So I turned it up really loud. And I just started like crying really hard. And I was like, what is going on with me? And I was just flooded with all these memories. And I was flooded with a memory of me and my friend, Magali LaFont. If anyone knows her anymore, let me know where she's at. I would love to touch base with her. But anyways, we did a talent show together and we did a dance routine to that song. And I was just remembering how I like went running out there and doing this like round off. And then I like, you know, was doing all my like jazz dance and hip hop dancing. And she was doing ballet. So it was like this perfect mixture. And I was just remembering that time of my life when things weren't that good. You know, at that point I had only gone through my parents' divorce and being molested for a while at that point. But other than that, you know, if I look back on that time, it's like, wow, life actually wasn't that bad then. And then I think about like all the things I went through since then, and I just started like crying. It was almost like I was just grieving for myself, like the different things I went through. And then I just started like praising God, like, thank you, God, that I didn't die. Like, thank you that I didn't OD. Thank you that I wasn't killed by my ex-husband. And thank you that my boys weren't killed by my ex-husband. And I just started like, it was like this like really hard memories. But at the same time, I was so thankful that I survived through all that stuff and how long ago that feels. And then, so it's like, I heard that song, you know, so that brought up this whole other thing. And then I heard another song on a Christian radio station that was something about a comeback. I forgot the name of the song, but it's like one of the newer songs. It talks about a comeback. And I started thinking, you know, with this retreat that I'm getting ready to do, it's like, I've been on a 13-year comeback. Like, seriously, I'm like a 13-year comeback. And you know, it made me think about that scripture, the one that I just said about how, you know, Jesus came to give us life and life abundantly. And, you know, compared to where I was 13 years ago, like my life, I'm living the abundant life. I am literally living what the Lord has for me. And, you know, I'm living out his plan for my life versus Satan's plan for my life, which is what I used to live. And the thing is, though, I don't want to settle for where I'm at. I don't want to be like, well, I've arrived. This is good enough. I'm living the abundant life and I'm not going to reach anymore. I'm not going to stretch anymore. I'm not going to try for anymore because I'm just good right where I'm at. And I don't mean like I'm not thankful for where I'm at because I am thankful for where I'm at. I don't mean like to not be grateful or thankful or at peace or whatever with where I'm at. I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying like, you know what? I'm still coming back. I'm still, you know, God still has more for me. Like that abundant life, that is a really full word. That is a word that is so much more richer and so much more in depth than I think we could ever possibly realize. And I just don't want to stop reaching, and I don't want to stop trying, and I don't want to stop praying and asking God for more. I don't want to settle. And so that's just really been on my heart. Like, you know, I'm so thankful for where I'm at, but I know that God has more for me. I know that that abundant life for me is more than what I have right now. And so there's nothing wrong with that. And these tears, like I seriously have been crying on and off like through this whole trip. I'm coming up like on my 13 year clean and sober, like in a week, and going to this retreat and getting to like talk to these women who prayed over me 13 years ago, and these women who have got to see me transform all this time. Like the privilege it is to get to now go back and inspire them and pray for them and teach them is like huge. And this is part of that abundant life for me. Like the abundant life for me is getting to use everything I've ever gone through to be able to inspire others and encourage others and call people out, you know, all that kind of stuff. That's an abundant life for me. And getting to be married to my husband, who's super awesome, is abundant life. And getting to be a mom to my kids and to, you know, a Gma to my grandkids. Like, I love all that. That is the abundant life. But the dream that God's given me about this ministry, this ain't nothing. This is so small compared to what God has shown me. And so I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to stop reaching. I'm not going to stop praying. I'm not going to stop wishing and hoping. No matter how hard it is to wait, no matter how long I have to wait, which waiting sucks and it is hard. But, you know, I just want to encourage all of you to really like ask the Lord, like, what does abundant life look like for me? Like my abundant life and your abundant life might be very different. Like, you know, I like taking care of my animals. I like spending time with them and, you know, picking up their poop and feeding them and brushing them and all the things that I do with them. I mean, I cut my goat's hooves. Like what? I'm like a little goat horseshoer. I'm like a goat shoer. I like do all this stuff, which to me is the abundant life. And to other people, that'd be like, gross. I don't want to do that. So I just really want to encourage you to ask the Lord, like, what does your abundant life look like? What does God have in store for you? And I really want to encourage you to, yes, be at peace and be still with where you're at in your circumstances, but don't be afraid to reach for more. Don't be afraid to ask God for more, to pray for more, to dream of more, and to really press in for that, because I just really believe, myself included, that we are settling for where we're at. And I really feel like God has more for you. Like the word abundant, I should have pulled this out before I got on here, but let me see if I can pull out my notes for this weekend. But I looked up that word, like abundant life. I looked it up online and just like, what does that mean? Because I know it's like a really big word, but what does it actually mean? And this is what it said on the internet. It said, abundant life refers to the life in its abounding fullness of joy and strength for mind, body, and soul. Abundant life signifies a contrast to feelings of lack, emptiness, and dissatisfaction, and such feelings may motivate a person to seek for the meaning of life and a change in their life. And I just think if I were to just literally read that over and over and over again, I'd probably get something different every single time I read it. But, you know, I want the abundant life. I have lived in lack for a very, very long time. Maybe not in recent years because life's, you know, pretty good now. But I want all that God has for me. And I don't want to wait till heaven to get it. And I know a lot of people are like, well, you know, let's see, I can't say that because that would have a bad word in it, but people say, you know, pretty much life sucks and then you die, you know, and a lot of people are just kind of like, God, I can't wait for heaven. I can't. Well, you know what? Why can't we experience some of that here on earth? Like, Jesus is in us. The kingdom of God is in us. Jesus Christ himself is in us if we are a believer. So I just believe we can have a whole heck of a lot more joy, a lot more peace, a lot more, you know, dreams and hope and a lot more power. Like, I mean, in the word of God, it says that we would do greater things than Jesus. Come on, somebody, like greater things than Jesus. Are we even coming close to anything that Jesus did? I mean, it's like I'm in full-time ministry. I look at stuff like that and I'd be like, when was the last time I raised somebody from the dead? You know, there's just things that I think we can still tap into. So I just really want to encourage you again, ask the Lord, what does an abundant life look like for you? And I want to encourage you to have courage, to be bold, and start pressing into him and asking him for more. Because that's what I'm doing. I'm asking for more. I'm asking for more opportunities to share my story, to encourage others, to pray for people for healing. I am asking for more power to be able to pull off the same types of things that Jesus did. I'm asking for more money for our ministry. You know, here's being really vulnerable. I know that a lot of people like to fake it till they make it. Well, I don't buy that at all. I'm not going to fake it till I make it. I'm going to be as honest and real with you guys with where I'm at, because I want you to see what it looks like as we grow, as I personally grow, but as our ministry grows too. Like, you know, just 2 days ago, you know, I looked at our bank account and all of a sudden I had several things come through all at once and I wasn't expecting a couple of those things to come through. And so I had to quickly call my husband and ask him to go and make a deposit from our personal account into our business account because we didn't have enough money to cover 3 bills and we didn't go negative. I caught it right in time. But, you know, after that happened, I just started crying and I was like, come on, Lord, like, you know, we've been praying for so long for you to bless our ministry financially. And so, God, I'm just asking that you would move. I'm asking that you would open the floodgates of heaven. I'm asking that you would pour a blessing into our lap that we cannot contain. And the only reason I tell you guys this stuff isn't because I'm trying to get you to feel sorry for us or even donate money. I want you to see what it's like, you know, where we're actually at, because someday we're not going to have a need for money. Someday God is really going to put it on people's hearts to make donations. There's going to be whatever, big checks written, or lots of people are going to buy our merchandise or something. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I want you to see that God is faithful even when we're not faithful. And I want you to see what it looks like when we don't fake it till we make it. We're going to be right where we're at and we're going to allow God to do what he's going to do. And so I just thank you guys for supporting us in the ways that you do. You pray for us, you lead groups, you tell people about us, you watch our Facebook lives, you share them, you do a lot of things to support us. And so I thank you for that. And my greatest prayer for you guys is that you would just continue to go all in with Jesus and continue to get unstuck from anything in the way of that and allow him to use you mightily. Like, you only get one life. So ride it till the wheels fall off. Like, go all in, get it, you know, get everything that the Lord has for you in this life and then give it all away. That is the abundant life, in my opinion, is to receive from the Lord in such a way that our cup overflows and that we get to use all that overflow to like bless other people, which is what I'm about to go do in just a little bit. So I think I'm 40 minutes away from my destination and got a little bit of time before my first, you know, time of speaking, which is at 7 tonight. I got 4 times of speaking this weekend, and it's really hot in my car. Sorry. I didn't want to roll the windows down because it's noisy outside. I'm in the city. Anyways, but I'm really excited about this weekend. I'm really excited about what the Lord is going to do through Purely His. And I just found out yesterday, I think it was, I was reading through like the retreat papers of like what to bring and all this stuff. And on there, I got a copy of what everybody else got. And it said ladies, as you know, every time we have a retreat, we like to pick a nonprofit ministry to give money to. So it's only natural for us to want to give money to Purely His, for Michelle's ministry. So bring some extra cash and we're going to donate it to Purely His. And there's also going to be a merchandise table set up. So bring money so you can buy a t-shirt or a sweatshirt. And I thought that was so cool. That was right after I was crying about, you know, not having enough money in our bank account to pay a couple of bills. And anyways, so it's just cool how the Lord's coming through, and for some reason he just keeps having me wait. So it's all good because I'm getting a better character as I'm waiting. It's just, it's a little difficult sometimes. So anyways, I look forward to the day that money won't be an issue, and then we can just fully focus on just ministering to people all the time and radically changing lives. And I don't usually get bogged down by the financial part of it. I don't usually get distracted by it, but there are those days, and it just so happened to be right before this retreat, and I think it was just like a distraction from the enemy. So but I'm gonna choose to live that abundant life. I'm gonna choose for this weekend to, you know, really get all that the Lord has for me, and I'm going to pour everything out that I got. I'm going to be going all in and all out this whole weekend and just giving these women back some of what they gave to me so many years ago. So anyways, thanks for watching. And let's see, I wanted to see what Darlene said. Darlene says, we can be grateful yet still long for more. Wanting more doesn't mean we're discontent. Totally true, Darlene. I am right there with you. Yes, Shannon. Sorry you're still sick. You'll get better soon. All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for watching. I do not have the names with me from last week of who, like, shared the broadcast and stuff. So I'm going to combine the ones from the ones that people shared last week, and whoever shares this week, we're going to combine those names together, and we're going to pick some prizes next week or some merchandise to give away. So if you share this video by next Friday, your name's going to go into a glass jar of some sort, and we will be sending you something. So it might be a t-shirt, might be a sweatshirt, a water bottle, a book, something like that. So anyways, I'm going to get off of here, and yeah, you guys have an awesome time, and please pray for us this weekend for the women's retreat. I just pray that lives will be changed forever, and no matter how many times their lives have been changed, that they'll continue to want more and allow the Lord to change them even more. So thanks for watching. Talk to you guys later. Bye.